Hello dear students, in this video lesson you all learn about solid state, in that classification of crystalline solids. The contents included in this topic are types of solids, types of crystalline solids, crystal lattice and unit cell, close packing and efficiency, types of void, imperfection in solids, electrical and magnetic properties of solids. This video is especially about classification of solids or types of solids. Let us see all about crystalline and amorphous solid. Usually you know in the previous video the difference between crystalline or amorphous solids. Solids can be classified as crystalline or amorphous on the basis of nature of order present in the arrangement of their constituent particles. A crystalline solid usually consists of a large number of small crystals, each of them having a definite geometrical shape. In a crystal, the arrangement of constituent particles are in order. It has long range order, which means that there is regular pattern of arrangement of particles, which repeats itself periodically over the entire crystal. Examples: sodium chloride and quartz crystals. Take an example given below. Here the constituent particles are in ordered positions and the regular pattern of arrangement of the crystals are there, and which repeats itself periodically over the entire crystals. Next, amorphous. An amorphous solid consists of particles of irregular shape. The arrangement of the constituent particles in such a solid has only short range order. In such an arrangement, a regular and periodically repeating pattern is observed over the short distance only. Such a portion are scattered and in between the arrangement is disordered. Example, amorphous quartz glass. This is an amorphous solid. Here the irregular arrangement of the constituent particles. Means the arrangement of constituent particles in a solid, they have the short range order. Here the regular or periodically the pattern observed is in the short distances only, and they scattered here and there. In between the arrangement is disordered. Come to know the meaning of anisotropy and the isotropy. Crystalline solids are anisotropic in nature. Means anisotropic in nature. Anisotropy in crystal is due to different arrangement of particles along different directions. Some of their physical properties like electrical resistance or refractive index show the different values when measured along the different directions in the same crystals. Take an example here, the crystalline lattice consisting of the constituent particles. So a cleavage here middle. And this side, the cleavage of one side, it shows the first green colored particles, then pink, green and pink colored particles. And the cleavage of this side become, first they are showing pink colored particles, then green color, pink and green color. Here the cleavage become different, this side cleavage become different. And let us consider here the diagonal. Diagonal arrow B, here the constituent particles are first green is there, then later on pink, green, pink. The constituent particles are in one by one. And this side the cleavage is different. And this above side the cleavage become different. Means the anisotropic nature is what? In a crystal, due to the different arrangement of the particles along the different directions, they show the properties in different directions in the same crystals. Then in case of amorphous solids, Amorphous solids, on the other hand, are isotropic in nature. It is because there is no long-range order in them and arrangement is irregular along all the directions. Therefore, value of any physical properties would be same along any directions. Let us see the anisotropy nature in amorphous solids. Here all the constituent particles are irregularly arranged. The nature is what? Irregular arrangement of the constituent particles along the all directions. Therefore, the value of physical properties would be same along the any directions. About types of crystalline solids. Mainly solids may classified into two types, crystalline and amorphous solids. Then in crystalline solids, again they classified into four types. These crystalline solids can be classified on the basis of the nature of the intermolecular forces operating in them into the four categories as molecular solids, ionic solids, metallic solids, covalent solids. Again, molecular solids can be classified into three types, non-polar solids, polar solids, and hydrogen bonded molecular solids. Then come to the first, molecular solids. Molecular solids are the constituent particles of the molecular solids. They consisting of the molecules only. Example, in non-polar molecules, they comprises of either atoms. For example, it consisting of H2 molecule, Cl2 molecule, CCl4, argon, helium, or the molecules formed by the non-polar covalent bonds are example for the non-polar molecular solids. Next, polar solids. Polar molecular solids, here the molecules of substances like HCl, ammonia, sulfur dioxide, etc. These are formed by polar covalent bond. Mean the molecule in such a solids are held together by relatively stronger dipole-dipole interaction. These solids are soft and non-conductors of electricity. Next, hydrogen bonded molecular solids. The molecules of such a solids contain polar covalent bonds between hydrogen and more electronegative elements, fluorine, oxygen, or nitrogen atoms. Strong hydrogen bonding binds molecule of such a solids like water. They are the non-conductors of electricity. Generally, they are volatile liquids or soft solids under the room temperature and the pressure. Then ionic solids. Ions are the constituent particles of the ionic solids. Such as solids are formed by the three-dimensional arrangement of the cations and the anions bound together by a strong electrostatic forces. Take an example of NaCl and the zinc sulfide crystals. Next, metallic solids. Metals are orderly collections of positive ions surrounded by and held together by a sea of free electrons. These electrons are mobile electrons and are evenly spread out throughout the crystals. Each metal atom contributes one or more electrons towards the sea of mobile electrons. These free and mobile electrons are responsible for high electrical and thermal conductivities of metal when an electrical field is applied. So, example for metallic solids, it takes place in metals, copper, silver, iron, etc. The conductor of metallic bond. Next, covalent solids. A wide variety of crystalline solids of non-metal, they results from the formation of covalent bonds between adjacent atoms throughout the entire crystals. They are also called as the Zeind molecules. So covalent bonds are strong and directional in nature. Therefore, atoms are held very strongly at their positions. The example for such a types of solids are diamond, graphite, polarins, means they are the network structures. They are in the network structures made up of the covalent bond. So covalent solids, they are also called as the network solids. Examples for this is as a diamond, graphite, polarins, like zinc molecules. Here some of the example, ionic crystals as a NaCl. It's covalent crystals, means molecular crystals, carbon dioxide and iodine, metallic solids example, here the sea of mobile electrons are there, and covalent are the network solids as a diamond and graphite. These are the zinc molecules. About classification with properties of solids. You know the types of solids as a molecular solids, ionic solids, metallic solids, covalent solids or network solids. Then again molecular solids classified as nonpolar, polar and hydrogen bonded molecular solids. In nonpolar molecular solids, the constituent particles are the molecules. In polar molecular solids, the constituent particles are the molecules only. In hydrogen bonded molecular solids, the constituent particles are molecules. In ionic solids, the constituent particles are ions. In metallic solids, the constituent particles are kernels in sea of electrons, means mainly the mobile electrons. Covalent or the network solids, the constituent particles are atoms. The attractive force present in molecular solids of nonpolar is dispersion or the London forces. In case of polar is dipole-dipole interactions. In case of hydrogen bonded molecular solids, consisting of hydrogen bonding. In ionic solid, the attractive force is electrostatic force. In metallic solids, the attractive force of metallic bonding is present. And in covalent or the network solids, the attractive force is what? Covalent bonding is present. Example for molecular solids of nonpolar is H2, I2, CCl4, argon, helium, Cl2 molecule, I2 molecule, etc. Then polar molecules HCl, SO2, these are the examples. Then in case of hydrogen bonded molecules, H2 is an example, ice. Then in case of ionic bonding, NaCl, cesium chloride. And in case of metallic solids, iron, copper and the metals. And in case of covalent or the network solids, SiO2, diamond, graphite are the examples. Then molecular solids are soft in nature, means the physical properties soft in nature. Polar also soft in nature, but hydrogen bonded molecular solids are hard in nature. So these all used as a insulators. In case of electrical conductivity, these all used as a insulators. The melting point for the non-polar molecule is very low, and for polar is low and hydrogen bonded is also low. Then in case of ionic bonding, the insulator in solid state but conductor in molten or the aqueous state. So the melting point of this type of solid is very high. In case of metallic solids, they are act as a conductors because of the sea of electrons or the mobile of electrons. They conduct the electricity. The melting point of this metallic solid is higher. Then in case of covalent solids, they are act as insulators. Their melting point is also very high.